Aloha, everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to Monster Fest 2018, and welcome to another edition of Mini of the Week. Today, we're going to have a look at a really unique miniature from Heresy Miniatures, actually funded through one of their Kickstarters a couple of years ago. This is Madam. Now, this is a very bizarre-looking miniature, an amalgam of several other creatures sort of all rolled into one. You have this hole that is part slug, part crab, part upside-down squid, part unicorn, part Jabba the Hutt-esque opera singer female. It's a really, really, really strange combination, but in the end, it works really well. This could be, in my opinion, a great substitute as a greater demon of Nurgle. This would be an absolutely amazing miniature to field in a Nurgle-style army. Now, barring the similarities, in some instances at least, between this miniature and Ursula from The Little Mermaid, it's a really cool-looking model. I mean, overall, like I said, it's got so many different elements that ordinarily, you know, you wouldn't think would work well together. When was the last time that you saw a slug and a crab combined into one piece? Or an upside-down squid and a crab, or Jabba the Hutt with a, you know, crab legs, or something like that. It's just a strange combination, and the individual elements themselves don't necessarily feel like they would work well with anything else, but once you combine them all together, it seems to function pretty darn well. Overall, a really, really, really cool miniature. One of those that, you know, it really needs a home either in a Nurgle army or maybe in some sort of a dungeon crawl. This is not even one, to be honest with you, that I would pick up to put on a display shelf because it doesn't have that sort of artistically appealing quality to it. It just has a really neat gaming vibe to it that, like I said, I think would fit very well in either a Nurgle army or some sort of dungeon crawl. Now, I can't leave this miniature, or I can't leave this video without pointing out what I think is perhaps the best element of this particular model, and one of the things that I think that Andy over at the Heresy Miniatures is so good at doing, and that is capturing the feel or the expression or the just the inner workings and emotions of the miniatures that he's sculpting. And here, Madam is no different. We have this wonderful pose with her arms and this sort of looking off to the left side in this contemplative stare, sort of like she's either, you know, really thinking about something or some sort of wicked, evil idea has just come to her mind, and she's almost got her fingers in that, you know, that steeple that you would see Mr. Burns take in The Simpsons, for instance, whenever he came up with some new scheme. It's just this sort of devious, devilish, sort of sickly sweet kind of appearance. And it's a really, really, really cool feature of the miniature. And to be honest with you, there's the other aspect of the model that I mentioned, Unicorn, I didn't even notice for a long time until I started the video for this particular Mini of the Week. She actually has a unicorn horn sticking out of her head, which is, it's so strange, but to be honest with you, when you look at it, it really covers up what would essentially be a very large blank area if it weren't there. So it works really, really well, and as I said, all of the elements really combine nicely to create a very unique miniature. Now, that all being said, this is a very expensive miniature. This particular miniature runs at 99 British pounds, which roughly converted over into US dollars would be about $130 to $135 for a single miniature. It is a large miniature. It comes on a 120mm plastic base, and you can see a size comparison compared to a basic swordsman style miniature, which I believe is also sculpted in the standard 32mm 28mm heroic scale that we are all used to, so you can see that it kind of matches up with sort of the earlier greater demons from like 2nd and 3rd edition of the Warhammer 40k or Warhammer universe. It's certainly not going to be on the same scale as the most recent Bloodthirster that they produced, or even the more recent Zinchian miniatures that they've done, where you have much larger scale models for the greater demons. However, I think it's a really nice model overall, and it might be on par, just looking at the size of it, it might be on par with, for instance, the Glotkin out of the Nurgle line. So it's probably very similar, but again, without actually holding the miniature in my hand, it's a little bit difficult to judge the size of the model. Again, overall though, very cool kit, sort of a haphazard kit, and definitely not one I would paint for a display purpose, but if I was doing a Nurgle army or some sort of weird dungeon crawl, and I wanted something cool to throw on the field that my player characters or my opponent was not expecting, this is definitely one of those miniatures that would fit the bill. Again, very cool miniature coming out of Heresy Miniatures. It's called Madam, and if you're interested in this model, it will be linked down in the video description. That's all I got for you guys today. I hope that you've enjoyed this episode of Mini of the Week. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions, and make sure to click that bell icon so that you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. Also, if you're enjoying these Monster Fest 2018 videos, please consider supporting me through Patreon. It takes a lot of work to get these videos going, and I would definitely appreciate your financial support. The link for that, if you're interested, is down there in the video description. Thank you once again for watching. I really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.